Good afternoon, I'm your host Nolan Brandes and welcome to On the Media. Today we will be discussing the interviews we conducted for our project. To start, I interviewed my aunt who's 46 years old and works at a high school. In this interview, she compared what high school was like back then to what it is now. She also explained the media she grew up with and how her life has changed because of that. And I'll introduce my other member.
So yeah, I'm Roberto Solis and I decided to interview my grandmother for this. She's 85 years old and her name is Sharon Solis.
So the first question is, what stood out to you in the interview? I'll start off. What stood out to me the most in this interview was how my aunt mentioned how back then technology was non-existent in schools and now it is existent in schools. So she kind of said that kids are learning to use technology in ways that it can be a distraction to some, but others it can be very beneficial. But for the most part, back then, if you wanted to solve a problem, you needed to ask for help. You couldn't just Google it like you can nowadays. And it made her realize it kind of helped her ask questions to people and communicate better. Nowadays, if you have a question, you can just Google it and look it up on the internet and get the answer right away. So I'd say that's the main thing that stood out for me. Yeah.
So yeah, for my interview, kind of our big discussion was that she really didn't rely a lot on media nowadays, besides some like select, you know, news stations on cable TV. She really didn't rely on like social media besides like Facebook and keeping up with like her friends and all that. And yeah.
And the next question is, what kind of media did they grow up with? And my aunt touched on this a lot. She kind of said when she was growing up, the only thing she had in her living room was a TV and computer. You couldn't take it anywhere. It wasn't like a laptop or anything. And the TV only had like a channel or two. You could only watch maybe a basketball game or a football game, and then you'd have a news channel as well. Her main source of media was the newspaper. She said if you wanted to look at like scores of the game or what was going on in the outside world, you'd really have to look at the newspaper, and you'd only get that each morning. And she said that nowadays, you look at, if you want to know an update to the score, you can watch a game on TV, or you can just look at your phone on the ESPN app. And but she also mentions how in high schools, each kid has a computer or an iPad they can learn on. Back then, you didn't have that at all. You'd have to write on a piece of paper. And that's the biggest thing that she said.
So yeah, so compared to the types of social media she had access to when she was growing up, she really only had access to like her daily newspaper and like local radio, whatever she turned on there. She did talk about during our interview when her family brought home her first TV and like just how excited she was. And she, at the time, she didn't, you know, feel skeptical of it. She was kind of amazed at just how advanced it was compared to everything else that was available at the time. But I mean, compared to like what we have access to now, like, you know, smartphones, internet, you know, it's, you know, it's such an upgrade compared to then.
Yeah, and going off that, iPhones, they didn't have those back then. And she said nowadays, in her classroom, kids will get distracted because they're always on their iPhone and they're texting people or they're scrolling through social media. And she kind of mentioned how social media is a very good thing because you can get a lot of information, but it can also be a very bad thing because it can be a distraction or it can just be something that affects your mental health. And that goes to our next question. What kind of media did you grow up with? Like, how is that different from what she or your grandma did?
So yeah, especially like as the generation that kind of grew up in like the rise of the internet and, you know, social media and all that, you know, I kind of had access to a smartphone, you know, a lot younger than I should have been probably. Yeah. But I mean, you know, like stuff like Xbox, you know, things like that, you know, we just have so much more access to things, especially compared to then, you know, radio, newspaper.
Yeah, for me, I got my phone in middle school, and my aunt said she didn't get a phone until she was out of college, which is kind of crazy to me. I couldn't imagine that. But I think the phone, for me, it helps me communicate with a lot of other people. Same with like the Xbox, you can get on your friends or you can reach out. She says that nowadays her phone, she uses that to communicate with her family while she's at work or family that's far away. And she says that's the most beneficial thing about cell phones and that kind of stuff. And the next question is, did their attitudes and beliefs change about the media over time because of technology? And when I asked her if she had any attitudes or beliefs that changed over time, she kind of said absolutely, because I feel like when you talk to an older person who hasn't experienced technology or grew up with technology, they kind of are very against it because they always see kids with their heads down on their phone. And she kind of says, like, at first it was like the coolest thing ever, and you could Google stuff, you could get information online, and it'd come up in a heartbeat. But now it's turned into something that, like, you can just Google, you get in a heartbeat, and like it's just normal in society. And she says that in her classroom she finds that very useful because she can use resources online and cite them when she's in her classroom, and it helps her teach in so many ways. And she said technology definitely has increased education in so many ways too.
Right. So yeah, so I would definitely say that her attitudes for media has changed over time. Kind of going back to what I said previously, she wasn't skeptical at the TV when it first came out. She kind of was amazed by it. But then, you know, as, you know, the internet started progressing, we got things like smartphone, people could just, you know, talk to someone at just like the type of a finger pretty much. She became a lot more skeptical of it, especially like in regarding like social media listening to you, you know, big platforms like that. But I mean, she also was like very concerned about, you know, the youth not being able to, you know, communicate face to face just because they were relying so much on talking on a screen.
Yeah, I agree. It's very controversial, and media has done a lot of good things, but it also has done a lot of bad things. And that's all the time we have for today. Thank you guys for watching. We'll see you next time.